Presiding Officer Juan Ponce Enrile wants a BSP examiner cited for contempt convinced the leaked Corona Bank documents came from the banking regulator. Ryan Chua reports.
Senators want to get to the bottom of the leak of the bank's signature card of Chief Justice Renato Corona that House prosecutors used to obtain evidence in his impeachment trial. PS Bank officials say they gave a copy to the Banco Central, which audited the bank in November 2010.
When were you required to submit the documents pertaining to Justice Corona? It was on the 24th.
Yes, Your Honor.
In what time?
We received the email sometime around 8:40 a.m. on the 24th.
And you submitted it to the examiner, Leal?
That, yes, sir.
Jerry Leal, an anti-money laundering examiner of the BSP, denies this. He says there's no certification from PS Bank that he received Corona's bank records.
I only asked the bank to tag the account of Chief Justice Corona electronically. And there is nothing in record to show that I received the documents nor asked that the documents of Chief Justice Corona be submitted.
But Senate President Juan Ponce Enrile is convinced that the leaked documents came from the BSP and that Leal is lying. Enrile moved to cite Leal for contempt.
He will not be released from the custody of the Senate until he tells the truth in this committee or until the Supreme Court will issue a writ of habeas corpus. I suspected all along that it was him who was the cause of this leak. We'll have to teach a lesson to bureaucrats who are toying with our laws.
A majority vote is needed to cite Leal for contempt and detain him at the Senate. Leal was also asked to explain in writing why he should not be punished. Prosecutors have said they got the bank records from anonymous sources, but PS Bank insists that the documents are fake, and the defense says these should not be accepted as evidence in the impeachment trial.
We have filed them a motion to have them excluded. They were obtained illegally, not in accordance with law.
Senators are still unsure if the results of this investigation would affect their decision on whether or not to admit Chief Justice Corona's bank records as evidence. What's clear to them for now, though, is that leaking the document violates the bank secrecy law, and they are expected to grill officials of the Banco Central on this in the next hearing. Ryan Chua, ABS-CBN News.
And joining us this morning to talk about the bank secrecy law is Attorney Trina Prodigalidad, a partner at ACRA Law. She's also chairperson of the Law Practice Management Committee of the Integrated Bar of the Philippines. Join the discussion by tweeting your comments and comments to ANC Mornings. Attorney, thank you so much for joining us.
Thank you for asking me to join you.
Yeah, we've been trying to find a resource person for all this. Looking at the Ryan Chua's report a while ago, what's going on? You have Senate President Juan Ponce Enrile wanting or citing in contempt Jerry Leal of the BSP because he said, Senate President said, I suspect you have been the one who leaked these documents. Can you help us understand this?
I think where the Senate President is coming from is that there is a categorical statement under oath by PS Bank's president that they actually turned over documents upon request of the BSP, and they identified a certain individual, and I think they even pointed to a particular email that indicates the request. On the other hand, the testimony of Jerry Leal is that there is no proof that I received it. So
let's make that clear. That's what he was saying. He didn't say I didn't receive it.
He did not.
There's no proof.
Yes, there is no certification that I received
Correct.
It.
Okay.
So I guess there's a disconnect between the two testimonies, and the Senate President feels that there is more reason to believe someone who states under oath and has proof that there was a request. Chances are, if the request was not complied with, there would have been a follow-up email on it.
And there wasn't.
There does not seem to have been
one. We didn't hear that there was a follow-up email.
No.
And that's on the record, at least the email.
Yes.
That's proof right there.
Yes, that there was a request for it.
Yeah. Yeah. Yes. Okay, so talking about the bank secrecy law, rewinding back to the impeachment trial on the bank accounts of the Chief Justice. Well, number one, of course, it's been ruled by the impeachment court that they will not allow the dollar accounts, because it specifically says that it can only be opened with the consent of the depositor.
Yes, the written consent of the depositor.
So that's fair. I mean, tapos na yon. There are no two ways of looking at that.
That is the law. Right now, the issue of whether an exception will be made by the Supreme Court is with the Supreme Court. I think there has been a lot of discussion that certain prohibitions in the Foreign Currency Deposit Act law have been made by Supreme Court decisions on the grounds of equity, to do justice, and you never know what the Supreme Court will do for this particular incident.
For example,
incident.
In that case that they were referring to in the past.
Yes, the Salvacion case,
yes.
Where they said that an exception to the FCDU prohibition on attachment and execution will be done in this case to do justice to the victim, the minor victim of a rape case.
But let's be frank here. This is the Supreme Court who issued a TRO on the motion filed by PS Bank.
Yes.
Okay. Kasi ang tagal na, no? We might be forgetting. That was a motion filed by PS Bank. The Supreme Court issued the TRO. In all indications, it doesn't seem like the Supreme Court will rule otherwise with regards to the bank secrecy law on the foreign currency deposits.
I think we have to take the temporary restraining order in context.
Okay.
That is not an indication of where they will rule on the merits. It's merely to avoid the injury that the PS Bank would have had to suffer. Because if they did not issue the TRO, he would have been compelled to give the information on pain of contempt before the impeachment court, or be subject to criminal prosecution for violating the FCDU law. So between the two evils, the Supreme Court had to give him relief.
Right.
So it doesn't really tell us how, on the merits, the Supreme Court will decide.
I just can't understand. I understand what you're saying, attorney, but I just don't see how the Supreme Court can rule that the impeachment court would be an exception to the FCDA.
The Supreme Court has in the past made exceptions where equity and justice will be served, and one never knows.
Okay. So just to be fair about it, let's wait for the decision the Supreme Court. Okay. But in the impeachment trial, where the peso accounts have been identified by bank officials, the only reservation that the prosecution has is on the dollar accounts, pending the resolution before the Supreme Court.
Yes.
With peso accounts, it's been clear that bank secrecy law...
There is an exception in impeachment cases, and in those situations, banks are allowed to disclose information and to allow inquiry into these accounts and deposits.
Now, let's go back to what people were saying in the past when this was a hot topic. If you are any person who doesn't want your bank or your peso accounts scrutinized, what you will want to do is open a dollar account, because it's very strict. Nobody can actually open your dollar account up until you have a written consent.
Yes. Well, there are other statutory exceptions, like the anti-money laundering law allows the EMLC to apply for a bank inquiry order with the court. And
but
then,
you have to have a reason for that.
Yes, you have
money
to have
laundering.
Probable cause.
Yeah.
Yes.
You have to prove that there's money laundering.
But the general rule would be, without your written consent, there can be no inquiry into your accounts.
Right. And looking back at the decision of the senator judges, some were saying that we are lawmakers, not lawbreakers. So if you're not happy with the FCDA, let's amend it.
Yes. In fact, the Supreme Court, in a lot of cases, has mentioned that, you know, this is the legal order we have. So until that law is changed, until the secrecy of deposits is either amended, modified, or repealed, particularly FCDU law, there's nothing that they can do, the Supreme Court, much less the legislators who made the law and who have the power to change it.
Do you think it's time that be amended?
I honestly think so.
Really?
The international community, particularly in connection with money laundering, has been very, has been urging the Philippines to bring us to the level of transparency that other countries have, and so far we have not responded. And at this point, we may still be, although we're considered compliant, they are thinking of putting us back in the non-compliant section.
So you are in agreement that the FCDA should be relaxed?
Yes, I think so.
Okay.
Certain exceptions must be provided.
For example, certain exceptions, which could be a number of things, possibly one could be an impeachment court.
Yes, or cases where there is supposedly anti-graft issues.
All right, okay. Looking at the impeachment trial, it's on recess right now, March 12th. How did you see everything transpiring as a lawyer and looking at, the legalistic point of view?
I'm actually part of the impeachment watch of the IBP, and so we monitor the trial. I think everything is going the way it would normally go in a trial. People may get frustrated that judges lecture, that there are procedural niceties that have to be complied with, but that's that's the rule of law you have to follow. So I think all in all, everything is going on as expected.
Were you, did you welcome the dropping of the 5 articles of impeachment?
I honestly feel those 5 may not be as strong as one of the articles that they're stressing, Article 2. And so I understand where they're coming from, because it will take a whole lot more evidence that will really test the patience of the court. So
yeah,
they might as well just have dropped it. I'm just not sure if procedurally it was done correctly.
Okay. Did it enter your head that possibly they're doing this because people are tired.
Getting tired,
and
yes,
losing
of their
interest.
Afternoon telenovela.
Yeah.
Yes.
So para tapusin na yun, na let's go to the defense after that.
Yes, because then they have only 3 articles to contend with. Chances are the evidence won't be as numerous and voluminous had they gone through the 8.
Okay, let's set the premise here. You are part of the IBP, Integrated Bar of the Philippines,
yes,
watch,
yes,
on the impeachment trial of Chief Justice Renato Cononde. There was a controversy back then, really trying to find out, because it seemed as if the IBP was pro-corona.
I think what it's better stated, that we are pro the rule of law.
Yes.
And as we saw the articles of impeachment and the process that led to it, initially, our sentiment was there may have been shortcuts.
Yes, because balikan na lang natin, attorney. I guess what we're trying to say is I wanted to lay down the premise that when the House of Representatives passed the impeachment, approved rather the impeachment against the Chief Justice, the IBP wasn't too happy because you felt that it was not done properly.
Yes, and certain items, certain articles spoke of collegial decisions of the Supreme Court that we felt the members of the House cannot question if it's correct or not, whether they were flip-flopping or what. It's a collegial decision. So when someone attacks a particular justice on the validity or correctness of a decision, it's not the proper forum to bring him to impeachment. That was where we were coming from. But, you know, now that the process has begun, the Chief Justice has effectively submitted himself to it. The issue is no longer whether the articles of impeachment were followed.
Yeah.
Right now, what we're trying to push is that the senator judges actually act as they have been required to do under their oath, to render impartial justice regardless of the politics and based on the evidence.
But there's still politics, you see.
I don't think anyone can avoid it. This is a political office.
It's a political exercise,
yes,
too, di ba?
Yes.
Hard to take that out of
the equation.
Yeah, out of the equation. So right now, you have been still keenly watching it, the defense. So far, what do you think of the 247? I mean, more or less, I'm sure you have an idea what these documents are. More than us.
Well, I think...
Madami ba yan, yung 247?
Well, marami. I mean, in ordinary cases, you don't reach that number. I've had cases where we reached more than that.
Okay.
But considering that I think every piece of document, every decision, every title, every paper was marked, it's not a surprise. So it's going to be really difficult for the prosecution to come up with an offer that is brief enough to be understood by the people. Right?
Okay.
And, easily resolved.
Okay, let's go to the start of the trial. I wanted to get your thoughts on that, on the SAL and the non-inclusion of certain properties in the SAL and etc., or even the cash assets of the Chief Justice. How did you see that play out?
Okay. I think it's hard to dispute whether certain assets were not included, certain deposits or money equivalents were not indicated. But it's hard to judge at this point because the defense has been stating that they have explanation. And until we've heard both sides, it's hard to judge.
Mm-hmm. Being an attorney.
Yes.
And supposed to be fair. Not being partial to any side.
Because that is where IBP is coming
from. Okay, but on the onset, kasi it's tama naman, looking at the prosecution, it seems as if
something wasn't there.
Yeah, but we have to wait for the defense
to explain.
The reason this wasn't there was because of this, that, this,
yes,
that.
Unfortunately, yeah. Okay. I think the how you fill out your sal-in, there's no set rules.
Yeah.
So they each get an accountant, they figure out how to do it. So there's no uniformity. So mm-hmm. I think that's where the problem starts.
What do you think about the the testimony of, was it PS Bank official when it was made public that the Chief Justice had closed two accounts the day he was impeached?
As I said, it's hard to take things without knowing the real context. Let's just say we are free to close our accounts whenever we want. So let's see what he has to say about that.
All right. It should be interesting, really, what the defense and how the defense will defend the arguments or the evidence laid out by the prosecution.
Yes, yes. And I understand from the defense is that one of their primary issues before with Article 2 was that it did not seem to indicate the fact that the sal-in was inconsistent. Mm-hmm. It was the mere non-filing. But
non-filing.
We are past that now, yeah. I think. So
pero
he has to explain.
Sa subtext, 2.1, 2.2, merong mga non-inclusion and non-disclosure. May non-disclosure 2.2, may non-inclusion 2.3.
Yes, but the article itself says non-filing, which
yes.
is the violation of the Constitution that they're talking mm-hmm. about. And then they say, we even suspect. So it wasn't okay. really an allegation that's based on anything.
Mm.
But we are at that point where I think that an explanation will be given or has to be given.
On a last note, Attorney Podigalidad, some are saying that if the Chief Justice is acquitted or convicted by the impeachment court, at the end of the day, he will be a lame duck Chief Justice. What do you think? Do you believe that?
If he is acquitted, I think his powers as Chief Justice belongs to the office, and if he retains it, he will continue to have those powers. Whether people in the court will see him differently after this exercise is something else. But if he is convicted, there's nothing much we can do. He will be removed from office.
All right. Attorney Atrina.
Yes.
Prodigalidad. Thank you so much
for joining
me this morning on Mornings at ANC. World number one, Novak Djokovic beats Janko Tipsarevic. Tipsarevic in the quarterfinals of the Dubai Tennis Champions. And Lady Gaga takes her anti-bullying campaign to Harvard. Stay tuned. You're watching Mornings at ANC.